Let's first discuss what the mother who actually recorded this video says happened. Now, she's the mother to one of those little girls, the aunt to the other. She says they were at Sesame Place, which is a theme park outside of Philadelphia, over the weekend. And as you can see, we're at the parade when she says that you can clearly see that Rosita, you know, gives a high five to the person next to them who is white. And then she says blatantly ignores the two little girls and alleges racism. Now, she says she tried to get the park's attention, tried to talk to a supervisor. That wasn't heard. So she posted this video along with her explanation on social media. And while that was heard by hundreds of thousands of people, it went viral. And the park did respond, as you asked, Allison. Essentially, the park said in part this: our brand, our park, and our employees stand for inclusivity and equality in all forms. That is what Sesame Place is about, and we do not tolerate any behaviors in our parks that are contrary to that commitment. And they offered this, saying it was a misunderstanding that they talked to the performer who was sorry about this, felt bad about it. They said that they were actually saying no to a person who's asking for a photo op by holding a child, which the park does not allow. They also said, you know, it's possible because of the costume they didn't see these two little girls. So again, this went viral. They offered up a second apology to the family in another statement. But as we know, this family has now hired an attorney and they're not putting this to rest.
All right. Bryn Gengrass, thank you. I'm joined now by Jodi Brown, the mother and aunt of those little girls. You see her there in the video, and her lawyer, B. Ivory Lamar. Thank you for being with us. Bryn walked us right up until the moment of that denial from the character. Tell us what happened, and when that moment happened, what went through your mind?
One, I couldn't believe that it happened. It's a child theme park. The kids are supposed to be, you know, happy and, you know, acknowledged and greeted and having a good time. So the fact that this even happened, the fact that this is even going to be a core memory for them when it comes to Sesame Place is actually disgusting and unbelievable to me. I, of course, didn't expect that to happen as I'm recording. I'm just trying to get their reactions because, as everyone can see, they're so excited. So to see the family next to me be acknowledged and to have them be ignored, and then the family right next to us be acknowledged. At that point, I have already stopped the video. It was heartbreaking. And in the video, you can also see how sad the children are.
Yeah. You say that, and we've talked around it, I want to be explicit here. You believe that whomever is in that costume did not high-five your daughter and niece, didn't hug Skylar and Nyla because they're little black girls.
Yes, because as you can see, now that I spoke up and released my video, now there's multiple parents who have similar videos with that character doing the same thing to the same race of children. So for me, that's not a coincidence at all. It's absolutely disgusting, and I do feel like the organization honestly really and truly needs to accept accountability.
Jodi, you see their crestfallen and disappointed after the Rosita character walks by. Did they say anything to you about that moment?
The character itself?
No, the girls.
The no-hand gesture. The girls, oh, in that moment, they're just, you know, sad. Like, how come he didn't, you know, give me a high five? What did we do? As you can see, my niece is still reaching out for him. So in that moment, you know, you want to console the children to tell them, like, it's okay, like, you didn't do anything wrong. Some people are just not good people, but for every bad person, there's going to be 100 more good people, and love is always going to, you know, outweigh your hate. But I shouldn't have these conversations with 2 6-year-old children. That's ridiculous.
Yeah. Jodi, let me turn to your attorney now, B. Ivory Lamar. First, there is an attorney as part of this conversation. Are you planning to file suit, B. Ivory?
You know, that is on the table. We would, you know, hopefully intend to work on resolving this matter short of litigation. I mean, the family is very clear with their expectations. They want a formal apology. They want the individual to be terminated. And thirdly, you know, this mental anguish that has been perpetuated upon these young 6-year-old girls is something that should be addressed also by the theme park. They went to this park on Saturday with the expectation of having a good time, enjoying themselves. They were very fond of those Sesame Park characters. And to leave out that park heartbroken, with their hearts shattered, is something that this theme park should take responsibility for. It has been echoed across this country from families that have been contacting my office. Phone is ringing off the hook with other families with videos showing similar outrageous, egregious conduct that this theme park has put up on these families. This is absurd, and this theme park needs to take accountability immediately.
Jodi, has the park reached out to you? We read their statements. Have you heard from Sesame Place?
When I first posted the picture the following day, they sent me a message to call to speak to a manager. She was supposed to call me back, and I haven't received a phone call back since the whole situation went viral.
And what do you make of their explanation that the person in the suit was not responding to the girls? They were responding to someone in the crowd who wanted them to hold a baby, and that's against the policy of the park.
In the video, you can clearly see the character looking at the children and saying no. I think that was just an excuse, damage control, because of the severity of where they see the video was going. But you can clearly see in the video that he looked directly at the children and said no. So I feel like that was an excuse, and instead of taking accountability, they were trying to, you know, sweep the situation under the rug.